The next important circuit is the multiplexer. Multiplexer is a combinational circuit that selects the information from one of many input lines. Okay, possibly we can have 2 power n input lines and directs the input to a single output line. Okay, this is also called a data selector, as it is directing the input from one of the many input lines to a single output line. Okay, so where it is used, say for example in the system we have a single data line, okay, which is called a bus, wherein it can be connected to the primary memory, say for example, and the data to the primary memory can come from either the register, that is the processor, or it can come from the secondary memory and so on. So the data that is coming either from the secondary memory or from the processor, that can go into, so we have 2 input lines here, okay, and each input can transmit say some number of data bits. Say for example, if it is a n bit register, then the size of the data bus will be n bits long. That is, at a time we can transmit n bits either from the processor, that is the register, or I can transmit n bits from the secondary memory. So n bits, so we will have n bits here, n bits here, and all the n bits will be connected to the primary memory here. The output line can be interpreted as a primary memory. Which of the input lines will be selected to transfer its contents to the output line is controlled by the select lines, okay, and there will be n select lines. Okay, this is a 2 to 1 mux. This is one information that is coming in. This is another information that is coming in, and this is the select line, and this is 0 and this is connected to 1. Okay, if select line is 0, we will transmit I0 to Y. If select line is 1, we will transmit I1 to Y, and that is what is indicated here. So we have 2 input lines and we have 1 select line. That will be, so either I0 will be transmitted to Y or I1 will be transmitted to Y, depending on the value of S. If S is equal to 0, I0 will appear in Y. If S is 1, I1 will be transmitted to Y. This is a 4 to 1 mux. So since there are 4 input lines, we need to have 2 select lines. So 0,0 of the select lines is connected to I0. 0,1 will be connected to, so 0 of this one and 1 of this one will be connected to I1, and I2 will have 1,0 in the select line, and I3 will be connected to 1,1 of the select lines, and all the outputs of the AND gate are connected to an OR gate, so that any one of the lines coming here will be 1. Okay, that is whatever information, okay, either 0 or 1, whatever we pass on here, that will appear here. Any one of the input lines will appear as Y, okay, and based on the select line values. This is a 2 to 1 mux, but for each of the input line we have 4 bits information, okay. So we can pass 4 bits either from A or 4 bits from B to the output Y. Okay, and there will be 4 outputs. See here, the setup is the same. Okay, we have, since we have 2 input lines A or B, we have only 1 select line. The 0 of the select line is all connected to A. Okay, and the information of A is connected to the AND gates, and we have additionally an enable input. If enable is 0, then none of the input lines are selected, that is Y is all 0. But if enable is 0, then we have these lines. So this is also active low enable. Okay, depending on the select lines, either A or B will be selected. And here the select line is all 1. Okay, for B, for all B AND gates, the select line will be 1. And the OR gate is connected like this. A0 of this or B0, that will appear as Y0. Either A or B of the bit position 0 will appear as Y0. And similarly, A1 or B1 will be appearing as Y1. And either A2 or B2 will appear as Y2 and so on. So each of the input has 4 bits here in this example. So we can have n bit inputs for each of the, so the data bus size is 4 here. Now let's see how we can use MUX to implement any Boolean function. Consider the Boolean function f with 3 input variables x, y and z, and we have function as 1 for the minterms 1, 2, 6 and 7. So we will use the higher order bits x and y. If we have n inputs, then we use n minus 1 higher order bits as select lines. Okay, and the least significant bit as the input to the MUX. So since we have 2 inputs for the select lines, we can have four input to the MUX. Okay, so we will use 4x1 MUX. So we separate this select line with the input of the MUX, and the function is 1 for 001, 1, 2, 6 and 7. Okay, and we can have a horizontal line separating the select lines. For these 2 inputs, the select line is 00. For these 2 inputs, the select line is 1 and so on. And we will write the function f in terms of z. So here f is equal to z. When z is equal to 0, f is 0. When z is 1, f is 1. Okay, so f is equal to z. Here f is equal to z bar. When z is 0, f is 1 and vice versa. So f is equal to z bar here. Here f is equal to 0 irrespective of the value of z, f is going to be 0. Here also irrespective of the value of z, f is going to be 1. So f is equal to 1. So these are the 4 inputs that we will supply to the MUX. So we have the select lines. Please notice that x is S1 and y is S0. Okay, so 0, 0, 0, 1 and so on. Okay, so this is going to be S0 and this is going to be S1. And the inputs are to the 0 input for the select 0. Okay, the input is Z. Okay, so we connect for the input 0, we connect Z. And for the select 0, 1, we connect the input z dash, and for 10 we connect 0, and for 11 we connect 1, and thereby we can realize the function, the Boolean function given to us. Let's consider one more example. Here we have 4 input variables. So 3 of them will act as select lines A, B, C. And D will act as the input to the MUX. Okay, and we have to find the input function to the MUX in terms of D. Okay, and we can see that for the first 2 inputs, the select lines are 0, 0, 0. Okay, and we can group it like this. Okay, for the same select inputs, we have to write the function in terms of the D input. Okay, and we can find that. And we can connect it accordingly. So here this is going to act as S0, this is S1 and this is S2, and that is what is given here. And since there are 3 input input to select lines. There will be totally 8 possible input lines to the MUX. 8 inputs can be connected to the 8 input functions that we have computed using the D input in the original function. Suppose if we are given only 4 to 1 MUX instead of 8 to 1 MUX, in that case we have to separate the select lines to be 2, because we have only 4 to 1 MUX, then we can have only 2 select lines. So AB will act as select line, and we have to write the function F in terms of C and D together. So in that case we will combine 4 rows together and find a single input F in terms of C and D. Okay, and we will have 4 input lines and we will have 4 to 8 MUX here. We have come to an end of the combinational circuit. From the next lecture onwards, we will see the sequential circuit. Thank you for watching this lecture.